The show is lit. You already know what it is. Young OG show. Teddy Ray, Lewis Belt. You know.
We out here. Make sure y'all subscribe, man. Keep watching. You know what I'm saying?
From LA to the bank. And all over the map.
Now it's my honor to introduce your host of the evening. This guy's a club favorite coming all the way from Oakland. You might have seen him on MTV. Are you the one? Start clapping now for the very funny Lewis Bell!
Yo, brother, man, you look dangerous. You just by yourself. Just... with a turban on, man. What that mean? I know you don't know nothing about no bombs or that, nigga. Oh, y'all sensitive in here. Well, it's gonna be a long night fucking with me. So you look sick, you waiting on somebody, sweetheart? You just here by yourself? I like you, you independent. You got a good job. When you walk around by yourself as a woman, I got money. I don't need nobody. You need some dick. That's what you need. I got it for you, man. Unless you gonna do it. Oh, shit. This nigga look dangerous right here with this hat. This nigga look like an upcoming rapper. Shout out some rappers. Any rappers in the house, make some noise. Woo. Yes! He look like, check out my mixtape ass face. That nigga came to the comedy show, the network. Hey, I like your jokes, but hey, check out this tape. Tired of niggas saying they rap. Like, if you rap at this point, let me just find out. Tired of, I'm like, damn, I know women gotta be overwhelmed because I'm tired of niggas saying this shit to me.
Nigga got my
you remember this
lip
pink.
Like, I got lip gloss. That's all done.
Yeah. But I like it.
Hey, man, shout out this brother right here, man. This is real. Talent. This is impressive. You know, I'm tired of meeting 50 niggas talking about their mixtape. You know what I'm saying? This is talent too. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got a rap to make it. You know what I'm saying?
He got a mixtape too.
You know what I'm saying? And they got his Instagram and everything on the back, man. You know what I'm talking about? But yeah, make sure you tap in with him. I don't want to pull his info out there, but you know. Yeah, man, that's real love, man.
But that's how you know you got a real. Black woman, like, I will see. I'm standing on what I stand on. Right. I need my hair done.
I've been working on it for the last 2 hours.
I'm in the car playing Words with Friends. Content.
We gonna get you out here
like,
fast.
Support. Like you right there. You on the other
I
side.
I ain't gonna lie, that's solid though. You sitting in the car.
It.
That's respect.
Right.
After 15 years of marriage, 20 years total.
Right.
I'm gonna see be at the house. She don't have to be here. All right.
Y'all ready to get the show started, though? I just had to come up here and talk a little shit for a minute. It seems like, you know, we got to get this energy high, though. You know what I'm saying? Y'all acting like y'all getting too much money in this motherfucker. You know what I'm saying? Get drunk. Get your drinks and everything. We got a lot of great comedians. We got a fire lineup. You know what I'm saying? The first comedian I'm bringing up, this is somebody inspired me so much. You know what I'm saying? He's self-made. He like, mark my words, he like the next Tyler Perry, but if... Tyler Perry can go on stage. I swear to God, you know what I'm saying? So y'all give a big round of applause for my man, Kevin on stage.
Appreciate y'all for coming out, man. My kids are home alone. That's true. My wife is in the car right now. She's black. She's like, my hair is not done. I was like, it's dark. She was like, my hair is not done. I was like, okay. She pulled out a butterfly knife. She was like, whoa, you don't I need to get aggressive. Listen, I want to just share this with y'all. Music, good music makes us trash people. I'm going to explain myself. Okay? Certain music we should not dance to, but if it's good enough, we will dance. So listen to the lyrics of this song. Y'all remember City High? Okay, had one fire song. Listen to the lyrics of this song with no music. These are the lyrics. What would you do if your son was at home? Crying all alone on the bedroom floor because he's hungry. And the only way to feed him is to sleep with a man, a little bit of money, and his dad is gone. So we're smoking rock now, in and out of lockdown. I ain't got a job now. So for you, this is just a good time. But for me, this is what I call life. Okay? Does that sound like danceable music to you? This is terrible. But when that song came on, what would you do if your son was at home? Crying all alone on the bedroom floor because he's hungry. And he's hungry to feed him. Sleeping in a man with a little bit of money. And his daddy's gone. There's a baby crying with no cereal on the floor alone. And you're dancing to his trials and tribulations?
That's a big ass word. I don't know what that means.
Is that a real word? Reverse?
No. Oh, you just made some ghetto shit up?
Her baby story, though, she doesn't have a mom at home. She doesn't have a dad that's working. Her baby's father is on crack and in jail. Obviously, this is not the usual situation. Gauge the room, man.
Thank y'all so much. I've been Kev on stage. Y'all been great. God bless y'all.
Me. I saw a white woman and almost caught a case. This was finna be a fucked up night. Already. What's up, Wawa? How y'all feeling, man? Welcome to the Young OG Comedy Show. Thank you to all the comedians I see. Well, just Kev. Shout out to that nigga. Any Hispanics in the house tonight? Okay. Damn, y'all feisty? What part of what Spanish are y'all? I'm about to be like, what part of Mexico? But I'll be fucked up because it'd be hella parts like Guatemala ain't in Mexico. It's hella shit. What's y'all nationality? Mexican? Straight up. Huh? Well, maybe she, okay, it's a tough time for Mexicans. She don't want to disclose her real shit. Maybe she don't know who in here. The ops might be in here looking for her ass. Mexicans be watching out for ICE like they the ops. Like, nigga, is that ICE? Niggas kick all the oranges over and walk away. I'm not selling nothing, I don't know. You ever see them Mexicans try to act like they wasn't selling them hot dogs? They get to pushing them carts fast.
I know, I ain't
seen. I'll be following them. How much? They two for how much?
It's an honor for you to slide through, man. You know what I'm saying? You wanted it. You feel me? You wanted a living legend. You know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
You're a millionaire. You just ain't got the money yet. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
that's all it is.
It's loaded.
It's loaded up.
It's you know what I'm the bank. About? Just give it to me. He's my key.
Exactly.
This is Trevor Wallace with the Young OG Show. This shit is fire. That's the hottest room in Hollywood right now.
I'm a little parched. I don't know why. Might because of the weed. Huh? What happened? You say something? Lady with the future hat, you say something? point to you, so everybody looking now. Now it's awkward, so you might as well say what you had said. Huh? Give us some weed, what? Nigga? I'm an LA nigga, I don't give niggas shit. But an excuse. Oh, the weed in the car, I'll be right back. Nigga, just pull off. Fuck out of here, give us some weed. I don't. Stop smoking bitches out when I was 20. Smoke me out, no. Fuck out of here.
Ready for a good-ass show. I know y'all are. Clap your hands. This is the Young OG comedy show. Yeah. Me and Louis, we started this show because we, you know, y'all don't care about the politics of comedy. Be like, oh, you gotta do this and that. But it's a lot of Young OGs out here just beating up the pavement, so vicious. And I'm proud of everybody on this show. Everybody's equally hilarious, equally successful. I'm obviously the finest nigga. We all got our strong suit. Shut up, Lou! I knew your gay ass was gonna say something. This nigga got all offended. Oh, hell no! Light-skinned niggas always got a respect. Cafe, start clapping your hands right now. Give it up for my boy, Mr. Trevor Wallace!
Going to Canada tomorrow. Ooh, not stoked on that. Well, here, okay, let me start this off real quick. Are there any Canadians in here? Good, fuck them. Well, see here, that was the most Canadian thing ever. You raised your hand so politely, you're like, I don't want to interrupt the show now. That'd be too loud if I put up too much wind with my hand. I like Canadian people. Canadian people are fine, but your guys have just a food group they just throw on us and expect us to like it, right?
They got a thing out there called poutine. You guys familiar with that?
Yeah.
Okay, but before I went to Canada this year, I had no idea what it was. But before I left, this dude was like, oh, you going to Canada? While you out there, you gotta get you some poutine. No other context, right? Now look, I'm not an idiot. I got a GED, okay? So I just took the context clues and I just figured that poutine was just slang for pussy, okay? Because the way he said it, he's like, while you out there, you gotta get you some poutine. I was like, shit, I hope, you know? Like, I waited 9 hours for this passport. Like, this shit better be A1, you know? And then he looked at me and he goes, well, you do eat poutine now, don't you? I was offended. Like, yeah, bro, I ain't DJ Khaled. What the fuck? I'll eat the poutine up right now, dude. I don't even need a to-go box, you know? They used to call me Poutine Pete back in the day, so bring me the poutine, good sir, you know?
Once a month, you know what I'm saying? You heard it from her. You know what I'm saying?
Sold out. Y'all bitches could never.
Never. Do too much
persist.
We outside.
Yeah, y'all worried about it. Y'all trying to get the last of them nachos, right? It must be expensive. Y'all ain't trying to make another order, huh? I'm chilling, Mary's. It's okay. You doing greedy as hell right now, though. Dumbass, cuz what's your sign? My sign is I'm trying to fuck around with you tonight. People, oh, I hate that sign shit. That shit get on my nerves. Cause people swear, you feel me, if you like, I'm a Taurus. So people be like, oh, I know Taurus. It's like, so if you know me, why the fuck you asking me all these questions? They don't know who you are, but they know everything. And then you tell them how you are, and they be like, see, yeah, that match a Taurus. Like, bitch, if you knew, I wouldn't have to tell you that. Oh, you say hella stupid shit. Taurus is like money. Like, I don't, if I was born in fucking October, I'ma like some money. Don't say that dumb ass shit. That shit was funny. That was just nigga shit. I was talking. These ain't even jokes. It smelled like one of y'all burped or something. That's a nigga in the front stank. Huh? It might be your ass. You over there covering your mouth and shit.
If I went up and just argue that junk,
just make it natural.
Make it natural.
You look like
yeah, and spark it up, and then be like, man, what about that motherfucker don't hit? Just let Nez go hit.
Can't have a thought.
Yeah, I can't think like that.
Netflix fucked up for bringing R. Kelly TV show back, though. I thought they was gonna let the nigga rest in peace. They blast him again. He on Netflix, the surviving R. Kelly. Give a round of applause if you seen that. Surviving R. Kelly. Damn, y'all ain't wanna clap, y'all. This shit suck. Nigga feel like a pervert for clapping, huh? Clapping this shit. We go to white people, who the fuck is R. Kelly? Nigga that let us down. That fucked black people up. R. Kelly fucking with kids and shit. Kidnapping bitches. I just didn't believe that at all. I'm like, R. Kelly, and he ain't gotta kidnap nobody. You know. I didn't believe it until I seen the first 2-3 episodes, you know. Because the first episode, I'm like, it's some bullshit. They hating on R. Kelly. You know. But by the time the second or third episode, I'm like, this shit kind of interesting. By the third episode, I was convinced. You know, because they start pulling up pictures. If you ever noticed, they had the stories, people was telling the story, R. Kelly kidnapped 3 girls. He's like, he ain't do that. And then pull up a picture of him wearing a Batman mask on with some drawers on or something. Start thinking, what? This nigga don't look like a kidnapper, man. Grown ass man wearing a Batman mask.
Teddy Ray and the Young OGs of comedy are always bringing laughter to my life. So I come out every chance I get. Make sure you come out, because if you're feeling down and you need a lift up, something to get you to go through the week, make sure you go to the Young OGs comedy show. That's what I do.
Keep that energy real high. We got one of the funniest female comics in the game right now. She's killing it all around the states. You know what I'm saying? I'm a huge fan of this lady. You know what I'm saying? So give a big round of applause for my good friend, Daphonique Spring. You know what I'm saying? Keep it going. Keep it going.
Hey
man, he bring out the hitter. Hey man, sometimes he call me like, hey man, I need a shooter. I'm gonna come out shooting. That's just how it goes.
I got real shooters.
That's how
I'm
it goes,
on the mic.
That's how it goes.
Do Too Much Presents, man. You already know what it is. We here every month at the High Comedy Club. No problem.
Young OGs. This is Young OG. I'm a Young OG.
Yo, I'm talking about Teddy and Young OG.
A Young OG.
Yo, I'm talking about me.
Hey, man, I'm about to be 30, nigga. It's finna be nothing but linen suits around this bitch.
Hey, man.
Short motherfucking
linen suits. Breaking
down. Stacey Adams and linen suits,
man. I'm talking about straight square tip shoes, man.
Me and my niggas ain't doing shit but hitting OJ concerts, nigga.
I'm wearing vests.
This next comic I'm about to bring up to the stage, this is, you know, a lot of comics come up with the intros like, oh, this guy's really fun. Like, no, nigga, like, this is genuinely one of the funniest minds I think we have in our class today. And I'm so honored for y'all to see him tonight here at the Young OG. So please start clapping your hands right now. And give it up for my boy all the way from Atlanta, Georgia.
Cut that shit off, man. Give it up for Teddy Ray in that sound like I'm about to die intro. What kind of shit was that? I think he wasn't the best in our class. We should enjoy him while he's here. Who knows how long it'll be? What the fuck are you? Just bring me a regular, dog. No, I'm just fucking around.
This shit here, I'm from Atlanta, you heard that. You from, where that dude from Georgia? You from Georgia? You from Georgia? What part? Snellville? Oh man, you don't get your ass out of here. That's where the radio stations cut out at. You can't get no hip hop in Snellville. That shit is all boot scootin' boogie and other shit. The devil came down to Georgia. What the fuck is this? What happened to 107.9? That shit crazy. You from Atlanta? I'm from Atlanta. That shit, Georgia, it's different. LA different. There's some differences. You wanna know the immediate differences I fucking notice? Immediately, first of all, people are in their area. In LA, you in your area. Wherever you supposed to be, that's where you supposed to be. They let you know with the name too. Koreatown, you supposed to be. They got everywhere, Little Armenia. Be over there and you ain't Armenian. You better be Little Armenian. You better be one of them. You got a little Baghdad. Chinatown, that's not the same as Koreatown? Hell no. I was like, well, goddamn. Black people, wherever you heard in them rap songs, that's where we at. We at that shit. And we'd be happy to see it, us anywhere else. You see another black person in the Ralph and Korea tape. Did you find the grits? Still can't find the grits.
We out here, you know what I'm talking about? You too much resistance on Young OG Show. We in LA right now, you know what I'm talking about? Fuck with Young Judge.
I fuck with them too because I was talking shit and they was just like,
yeah, oh my God.
But I didn't say I didn't roast y'all. I was just like, ooh,
hey, you was going, hey, my man, what the fuck are you?